Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Did you guys see that? I actually forgot that I had glasses on. That. I'm still getting used to it. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin, and today we are listening to Janis Joplin with the song Peace of My Heart. Now, as I was looking for artists and bands to explore, I came across Janis Joplin, a very well-known and well-respected name, but as I was looking through her top songs and her most popular songs, I realized that I didn't know any of them. Like, I just went through and kind of sampled like 5 to 10 seconds of them, and I can't say that I've ever heard any of them. Usually, I reserve one day out of the week to record, and this weekend I was actually going to be very busy, so I kind of pre-recorded a little bit more so that way I could kind of compensate for the days I lost. Well, turns out that everything that I had planned had fell through in one way or another, so I ended up recording actually every day this week. I recorded Friday, Saturday, and today, Sunday. Now, I didn't do like long sessions or anything every day. I've only done, I think on Friday I might have recorded maybe 4 or 5 songs. Yesterday on Saturday, I recorded 2. Today, we'll see how far I kind of feel like going. So anyways, of course, you guys can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below for discussion. Please let me know, of course, what you think of the song. And without further ado, this is Janis Joplin with Peace of My Heart. That's just a classic rock and roll song. I can easily see why Janis Joplin and her voice is so distinct. It's so well, let me turn my microphone up a little bit, just right about here. Absolutely amazing voice, absolutely full of emotion and passion. And I love when you can hear that in a singer's voice, because she has a nice voice on her own. With her voice and her vocal, she has a very rough gritty style in her singing and in her delivery. But let's take that out for just a brief moment, and you can hear the beauty in her voice. She hits the notes beautifully. Everything's on key. She sounds great. But it's that little extra grittiness and that little rough texture in her voice that really sells the actual emotion and passion of the song. Like, she's actually singing herself. No. Let me rephrase that. She's really singing her soul. This song, you can definitely hear how blues inspired rock and roll. And in going with that, you have to be able to emote properly the emotion that's with that. Blues is usually and primarily a sad. It takes sad topics and it speaks about those. When you have a pain like that, like an intimate, romantic pain, like a relationship that either didn't work out for whatever reason, breakups, heartache, all of that. When you have such a strong emotion, you need to be able to carry it. You need to be able to deliver it in a way that actually sounds like you're hurt. You don't want it to sound fake. A lot of singers will sing about heartache and will sing about, you know, failed love. And are they hitting the notes and does it sound good? Absolutely, can't deny that. But does it really sound like they feel that way? Kind of like with Kate Bush and Peter Gabriel. You can hear the emotion behind it. So here with Janis Joplin, absolutely 100%, she perfected that. The emotion is there right from the beginning, and her voice clearly speaks that. And this is with her band, Big Brother and the Holding Company. And the instruments were great too. The bass sounded a little bit reggae-ish, a little bit to me, maybe funk. The guitar really sounded kind of reggae. Like, I don't know, there was something about it. And then the drums, very nice the whole way through. The fills were great. There was a lot of that going on. Like I said, it's a lot of cues from blues music. So this sounds like a slightly grittier take on blues, which a lot of classic rock and roll was. Now, I'm reading Genius, and that's what I use for the lyrics. And I just happened to see on the side that this song was sampled in Piece of My Heart by Shaggy. Some of the backing riffs kind of sounded very familiar to me, but I know I haven't heard the song. So really quick, I just want to hear a little bit of that song to see if that's what I connect it. Because I don't know where I've heard that before. I'm just going to look it up really quick. Let's see. Never enough, but I'm going to show you, baby, that a woman can be. Is this the girl, My Darling song? So come on, come on, come on, come on. So you have me under pressure. I'm sorry, but y'all gotta admit that Shaggy kind of sounds like a Jamaican Kermit. I mean, you're under my pressure. So yeah, it's a great song. I haven't heard the Shaggy song before, I guess. It just kind of sounded familiar. Lyrics. Verse 1, didn't I make you feel like you were the only man? Yeah. And didn't I give you nearly everything that that a woman possibly can? And then the chorus, take another little piece of my heart now, baby. Oh, break it. So, yeah, there's a relationship between whoever it is, between her and the guy, I'm assuming. And it's like she's in a bad relationship. I mean, basically, she's in a bad relationship. And every time maybe they get together or whatever, like, he just breaks another little piece of her heart. He just hurts her a little more. But for whatever reason, she keeps coming back or she stays in the relationship. You're out on the streets looking good. And baby, deep down in your heart, I guess you know that it ain't right. Never, 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 never hear me when I cry at night. Babe, and I cry all the time. So maybe he's stepping out. Now, this is a cover of a song. I didn't know that. I'm just reading a little bit. It was originally recorded by Irma Franklin in 1967. I'm just reading from Wikipedia. A cultural writer, Ellen Willis, had wrote that Joplin had used blues conventions not to transcend pain, but to scream it out of existence. Very interesting thought, because she does, yeah. It's not to transcend the pain, it's not to get over it. It's to just completely obliterate it and just there's a better word than what I'm going to use for this, but she uses her vocals to release the pain in such a way that it is totally, totally clear and out of her. Like, she doesn't feel it anymore because she got it all out. She got it all out. It's an emotional vomit. Okay, maybe that's not the best way to say it. But I think you guys know what I mean. Anyways, yes, I would listen to this song. I think it's right on the, like, between a, like, a passive listen and an actual I would listen to this. I really do like her voice. I think that's the main catch for not only myself, but probably a lot of you guys that are familiar with her and her music. So I would like to listen to more music because I like her voice and I like the way that she sings. It's very emotional. It's very passionate. And I like that. So, of course, let me know what you guys thought of the song. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below for discussion. And I hope you have a great day, guys. I'll see you later.